Hello and welcome. Welcome to your stretching portion of your class. My name is Heather. I'm going to take you through a several minutes of some post-workout stretches. If you would like, you could grab a mat. You need nothing else today, no props. I'll have the stopwatch nearby. I'm just going to run us through some lovely stretching that should hopefully assist you during post-workouts, or if you have a few minutes free from your day away from a desk, you can certainly do these pre-bedtime in the morning. We're going to take advantage right now of some space on our mat. If you could, let's lie down on our backs to begin. Find your floor space or your mat space. We'll extend our bodies fully. So if you want to listen with your ears, we're going to put our heels to touch and our toes will fall open, resting our arms at our sides to begin. You have a slight tuck in the chin, shoulder blades are underneath you, and if you would like, close your eyes. Take a slow inhale through the nose and open your mouth and exhale. Repeat that. Notice if you're holding tension in the feet or the hips and the thighs, perhaps the jaw, the forehead. We will start our stretches from this position. This is a supine position or face up. I'll have you bend your knees when you're ready. No rush. Situate your hips and shoulders as you need. We'll take our right leg, extend it up to the sky. You keep the knee bent to start. We're going to grab the back of our leg with both hands, and I want you to grab separate spaces on the leg. So grab the back of the thigh and maybe a little lower down with the other hand, or walk down farther if that is in your range of motion. I want you to keep the toes flexing back. If you can reach the toes, I like to just grab onto my toes to help accentuate this stretch as we're taking on the hamstring. And the more flexibility, or excuse me, flexion in the ankle we can get right now, you'll feel that bend through the calf muscle and perhaps the Achilles tendon just above the heel. You'll know right away when you've met the match. If you find this point of resistance in the back of the thigh, just hold. Keep your hips pressing toward the floor and find that breath that we just talked about when we first settled. We're going to slowly release. Let that stretch just ease out as you take the same leg, right leg, ankle on the thigh now. We'll take a supine figure four stretch. You'll lift your left knee. So your right ankle is now hooked onto the left thigh. You'll press your left knee towards your chest. Both feet stay flexed as you reach behind with both hands. Clasp them if you can behind the left thigh and draw your left knee towards your chest. Lots of little things potentially taking place here, depending on your flexibility and your range of motion in the hips. If you can keep the hips pressed toward the floor, please do. Shoulders are down on the mat, elbows are close to the rib cage. And I like if my right arm is in contact right now with my right leg, I just give it a gentle push. You should feel this in the outer hip. In about 10 seconds, we're going to add a little bit of hamstring threading, if you will. So, with our left leg that is currently supporting the right leg stretch, we're going to take advantage of some hamstring love here. When you're ready, you can straighten the left leg and bend. Flossing, I think I called that threading. We'll take it. Straighten and bend. Just a few more seconds here. We'll release and we'll switch legs in five, in three, two, and one. Carefully release both legs down. If you would like to take a moment between straighten your legs, you can feel the notable difference from right leg and left, the stretched versus the non. Some blood flow working its way back into the muscles. Let's bend the knees again. We're going to switch sides. We'll start with the hamstring stretch on side two. Lift your left leg now. You're going to bend the knee again as much as you need. Separate the hands and grab the back of your left leg. Pull it toward your left shoulder. If you can walk the hands farther down, try it. Flexing your foot, see if you can reach for the toes. Find that point of resistance for your hamstring. Let's check in with our posture or our alignment. Hips are pressing toward the floor. Your gaze should just be straight up to the sky. Find your inhale and your exhale. Every exhale, an opportunity potentially to just squeak out a little more range of motion in the stretch. Stretching tends to not be super comfortable depending on the muscles, depending on your body. Never forcing our body into positions that are not safe or feel right, but certainly if you have a little resistance in your body, that's normal. Carefully release. We're going to find the figure four stretch again. So now the left ankle on top of the right thigh, lift your right knee up, giving that press on the left leg. Flex both feet, clasp both hands behind your right thigh, draw the knee to the chest. Check in and make sure your feet are flexed. If the left arm is in contact with the left leg, give it a gentle press. Elbows close to your sides. It's a very compact stretch, keeping the focus on the hip, but oh, there's so many wonderful benefits of this stretch. See if you can find a few deep breaths here while we hold. In about 10 seconds, we'll take on the flossing again. If you tried it on side one, we'll try it on side two. Otherwise, you can just remain right where you're at. When you're ready, we'll straighten the right leg and bend the right leg. And when you're ready, we're going to slowly release. Let's let both legs once again release all the way down. One full body stop right here just to relax. Let's re-engage the core as we bring the knees back in. Let's find spinal rotation. I want you to bring your arms out to the sides, not directly outside of the shoulders, a little below the shoulders. Bring both knees up, and I want you to gently bring them down to the right. Our goal right now is to get both shoulder blades to stay on the ground. So if you feel like you're lifting off the floor on the one side, split your legs so that the top leg is closer to your shoulder. So my right shoulders were closest to my legs. You can keep the gaze directly above, or you can take your gaze to the opposite direction where your knees are. At no point should your legs be dangling in the air, so make adjustments as needed. Again, you can straighten the body. Range of motion feels... Also, keep both knees bent and draw the knees up toward closer to your shoulder. We're going to switch sides in 3, 2. Carefully come back to the center. If you can keep the legs up, great. If you need to set them down to shift your body around, which I need to do to clear some space, drop your knees down to the left. Again, find that position that works best for you so that you can relax in spinal rotation. You should feel some relief out of the lower lumbar spine. Hips are trying to relax. Again, you have to find a position for your legs to do so. And once you get there, do you want to look up to the sky? Do you want to close your eyes or maybe take your gaze opposite of the legs? One more inhale and exhale here. Carefully bring the knees back up. If you can, keep them in the center above your hips. Reach your arms around the front of your shins, just below the knees, and give yourself a nice hug. Squeeze the knees to the chest. If you have the range of motion and you can grab a little bit farther in, opposite hand to opposite elbow, same grip with the forearms. You're going to drop the head back down, squeeze the knees together, pull the shins down towards your hips. And hold. Carefully release. This time we're going to bring ourselves up, seated position. Rock yourself up or turn to one side and push yourself up into a comfortable position. You have an option to sit right here with your legs crossed. You could sit in the kneeling position. Get a little bit deeper stretch for the knees. And if it's in your wheelhouse, you can drop your hips between your heels. My only request of this stretch is that knees are forward, heels are touching hips, and toes are pointing directly behind you. Any of those positions are absolutely acceptable. I want you to bring the shoulders up to the ears, round them back and down. Again, shoulders up, little shrugging into the trapezius and the neck. From your seated position, wherever you've landed, I want you to bring your right arm directly behind your back. You can probably see my arm in the mirror on the video. So I've just got my forearm in contact with my back. From this position, right arm is behind you. I want you to take your ear opposite direction. Not forward or back, but ear directly down. You should feel a really deeply rooted stretch in the arm that is behind you. Carefully release the arm that's behind you. I want you to extend it directly out of the shoulder so it's parallel to the floor. This is one of those stretches that's a little bit of a surprise. You might feel some tension or tightness through the neck or the shoulder. We're not here very long. Three, two, carefully bring your arm down to rest and then gently roll your chin forward and let your head just hang naturally here. You can close your eyes if you would like for just a moment. We're just creating some length in the spine through the cervical neck area. Gently bring your chin back up. Let's try the other side. Take your opposite arm now, your left arm. Bring it behind you so your forearm is in contact with your back, low back. Take the opposite ear and let's drop it down. If you're seated in the position I'm in, we're getting a bonus long stretch for the knees and the ankles here. When you're ready, gently release the arm from behind. You're going to bring it directly out, parallel to the floor. Continue holding ear towards shoulder. Gently release your arm, and I want you to slowly bring your chin back down toward the chest one more time. See how heavy you can make your head hang here and shoulders, just let them depress down. No rounding in the upper or mid back. And bring your chin back up. One more stop for us. If it's possible, I want you to meet me in a kneeling position. Let's get a little bit of a chest expansion stretch here. So from kneeling position, my feet are flat underneath me. I'm going to bring my hands behind me. I'm going to draw my shoulder blades together, draw the hands down to the floor. This is a great starting posture. If you feel pretty flexible here, you don't feel any pain, feel free to take your forehead to the floor, bringing your arms up toward the ceiling. And then as you lift up using core strength, you can release the hands, set them back, open the chest here as well. Move between both of these movements. We'll take about 10 more seconds. Last three, two, and one. Let's find comfortable seated one more time. As we finish our stretches today, I want to just thank you for taking time for yourself. Super important, in my opinion, that you find time to stretch the body, especially in winter months and especially when you're under a lot of stress or you're hitting the gym a lot. It's important for your joints to have some management for longevity. I always say, mobility is longevity. So take good care of yourselves. Let's take a deep inhale up and exhale the arms down. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining. If you have questions or feedback, I'd love to hear from you. Again, my name is Heather. I hope to see you again at the Healthy Living Center. Take care.